having me here. After all these interesting presentations about immunology, chemotherapy, breast surgery, I'd like to come with the a proposal to discuss surgery for metastasis, in particular liver metastasis. So approximately 5 to 10% of breast cancers are metastatic at diagnosis, and eventually up to 50% may become metastatic. And traditionally, the survival range for metastatic breast cancer was between 3 and 6 months, and with current oncologic treatment, rarely exceed 15 months, especially in the liver setting of metastasis. Why talk about liver resection? So basically, I'm proposing you to think whether a patient, let's say 65-year-old patient who has metastatic breast cancer, who has one metastasis in the liver and maybe several metastases in the bone, can be sent to the surgeon for liver resection. That is my question, and that is why what I'm going to try to clarify here to the best of my knowledge. The idea started with the model of liver resection for colorectal cancer, and in colorectal cancer, liver resection was tremendously successful and is now standard of care, giving a survival at 5 years close to 50%. So the question arises whether the same model can be applied for other cancers. Why for breast cancer? Because liver metastasis shorten life more than, for instance, bone metastasis, which are more compliant and may allow survival for 50 to 60 months. So maybe liver surgery may be regarded as a way to ensure the prophylaxis of liver failure in breast cancer liver metastasis. When you try to evaluate a procedure, first of all, you have to ensure its safety. And I'm showing you here a paper from 2003, which is 12 years ago, from the United States, where they define the liver resection as a common procedure with low morbidity and low mortality, especially in high centers, but it's now becoming increasingly performed in high and middle centers. I'm showing you here a few papers published in the last 25 years, and I have to mention that there are very few papers on the matter. The largest study of liver resections that we could find comes from MD Anderson with 86 patients in 12 years. So from a large liver center, a frequency of resection of about 8 patients per year. In our own study, we have 43 patients over 13 or 14 years. And you can see mortality in most studies is zero, while morbidity ranges from 13 to 22%, and generally there are very few, there are complications, there are minor complications not requiring reintervention, pleural effusions, bile leaks, hematomas, wound infections, urinary tract infections, pneumonias. So we can say it's pretty safe. Does it improve survival? Again, we would need a prospective trial in which some of the patients would undergo surgery and other patients would solely be medically treated. But we do not have such a study, so we can only compare to the 10, 15 months currently accepted in literature for metastatic breast cancer as survival. So we have survivals, median survivals, 27 months in the study of RAB, 34 in the study of Yashimoto. In the study of Vlastos, we have 63 months. In the MD Anderson study, 57 months. In our own study, 32.2 months. So it would appear it's considerably longer than the survival of patients who are only medically treated. We found a retrospective study done by the team of Institut Curie in Paris, where they retrospectively matched 50 patients who were resected to 50 patients who were medically treated, patients similar in age, tumor burden, hormonal status, in many aspects. And you can see the two survival curves. The patients who underwent resection lived longer. So it would appear that there is a survival benefit, to the best of our knowledge so far. How about the patients who have also other metastatic sites, which is the case of most of these patients? And I will refer myself to the study of Professor Adam, who enrolled 85 patients, out of which more than 50% also had other metastatic sites, and he obtained a survival of 32 months, a median survival, and a five-year survival of 37%. Should we perform chemotherapy? Because today there was a lot of talk about neoadjuvant chemotherapy, neoadjuvant hormonotherapy. Should we judge the same in a metastatic setting? And the MD Anderson study says yes, and liver resection should be performed once the best shrinkage, the best response of the metastasis was obtained by chemo hormonotherapy before surgery. And there is actually a narrow window of opportunity before chemo resistance develops when surgery should be applied. Should it be performed in elderly patients? In our study, we had, out of 43 patients who underwent resection, we had 5 patients over 70 years old who didn't behave in any way differently than the general group of patients in morbidity, in mortality, and in age-correlated survival. So who should benefit from a liver resection? Because it's clearly not a procedure that can be generally applied. There is a select group of patients who can benefit. And regarding retrospectively the literature, we saw some factors that might have some kind of impact. The size of the breast tumor and the nodal status are generally considered not correlated with survival after hepatectomy. So the breast tumor and the breast tumor procedures are a separate event and seem to have little influence on what happens after hepatectomy. What appears to be an important factor reflecting the biology of the tumor is the disease-free interval between the tumor event, the tumor surgery, the breast tumor surgery, and the detection of breast liver metastasis. A longer interval signifying a better prognosis after hepatectomy, longer interval being at least 1 year. Number and diameter of liver metastasis, the greater the tumor burden, the worse the prognosis should be. However, in most studies, they found no correlation between the number and diameter of liver metastasis as long as they're fully resected. As always in surgical oncology, resection margins are of utmost importance, an R0 resection being desirable, and the patients in whom an R0 resection is performed live longer. And finally, but not the least, the primary breast tumor hormone receptor status appears to be of crucial importance. Patients who have estrogen and progesterone positive tumors live longer after hepatectomy. In our own experience, we proposed the procedure to 52 patients, out of whom 43 patients underwent liver resections. 2 patients underwent radiofrequency ablations, and in 7 patients we found a greater extent of disease which we didn't suspect on imaging. Most of them received neoadjuvant chemotherapy prior to liver resection. The characteristics of the breast tumor are of all kinds. We had T1, T2s, we also have T3, T4s. The stage of disease, of the initial disease, was ranged from 1 to 4. We also have 4 synchronous metastases. And the hormone receptor status in 22 patients, we had ER positive, in 5 patients negative, in progesterone, in 22 patients we had progesterone positive, in 5 we had progesterone negative. So it was a rather mixed population. As far as liver metastases were concerned, we first operated on solitary metastases, and then we switched to being more permissive and operating on multiple metastases. The number of solitary metastases, of patients with solitary metastases was 24. We had 19 with multiple metastases. We had 29 patients with metastases under 5 centimeters. We had 10 patients with metastases above 5 centimeters. As far as the liver resection required is concerned, we had minor resections in 29 cases, but in 14 cases we had major resection, which is more than 3 segments. Generally, we managed to obtain an R0 resection in 39 cases out of 43. And as far as the results are concerned, we had consistent with other studies, 0 mortality. And we had morbidity in 7 patients, which is 16.2%. We had two biliary leakages, 2 intra-abdominal abscesses, 1 urinary infection, and 1 wound infection. As far as survival is concerned, we obtained a median survival of 32.2 months and a survival at 5 years following breast cancer liver resection of 58%. So at 1 year, we had 93% following liver surgery, at 3 years, 74%, and at 5 years, 58%. What is interesting to point is that the longest survival following hepatectomy was 123 months in a patient who never relapsed in the liver. The patient ultimately developed bone metastasis, but the liver seemed to be protected from relapse. We found correlation with estrogen and progesterone receptors. Patients who have positive estrogen and progesterone tumors live longer. We also found a correlation with liver burden, liver tumor burden, meaning that the maximal site of liver metastasis and the number of liver metastasis negatively impacted on survival. The more metastasis and the bigger they are, the less patients live following hepatectomy. And there is a question which naturally arises, what happens if recurrence occurs in the liver? Do we apply the same principles of resection? And we had 6 patients out of 43 who underwent a second liver resection, and overall survival after re-resection was 28 months. We also had 2 patients who underwent a third resection. We had long survivors. The patient I was telling you about with a survival following the first liver resection of 123 months. In conclusion, we do believe that hepatectomy may play a part in the role of metastatic breast cancer, which should be integrated in the multimodal treatment, chemotherapy, immunotherapy, hormonotherapy, and the indications are yet to be clarified. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Bakal Basa.